What's going on, guys? Welcome to the Coach Malik Show. My name is Malik Benoon, and I am going to be your virtual coach. I'm going to give you the knowledge, the tips, and the advice to help you perform better in all aspects of your life. What's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of The Coach Malik Show. It is September 1st, Saturday. Good day. Met with my friend Jordan. This vlog is not going to be super edited. It's just going to be this clip plus a little bit of clips of my workout. Today, obviously, the title, it is five things to help you transform your body. And it's really, you know, I was talking to Jordan, like I said, I met with him today, and these things are going to change the way you think about training, change the way you, and you could use these five tips for anything. It doesn't just necessarily have to be fitness. It could be in your work, it could be in your relationships. You know, these are things that that I've used. These are things that I've given clients to have them use, and it really works out well if you just put them to use. All right, the number one thing is tracking. Guys, if you're trying to transform, all right, transform. Once you reach your goal, it's gonna be a lot easier to stay there, I promise you. It's gonna be so much easier to stay, once you achieved your goal, to stay there than it is to get there from where you're at. This transformation, the reason so many people have such a hard time doing it, it's why a lot of people can't do it, is because they quit and they give up because it's so goddamn hard. So what you gotta do, number one, is track, all right? Track your progress, track your nutrition, track your workouts, track everything so that you're able to go back and look and be like, you know, where did I mess up? Where did I plateau? And then 30 days, 60 days, 90 days down the road, you're gonna be able to look back at day one, because look, you're gonna be on your process, you're gonna be on your journey, and you're gonna not be thinking, you know, you're seeing results. You're gonna be like, oh, you know, I'm doing this for no reason. But when you look back at your goals and you look back at your journal and you look back at what you did day one, you're gonna look at those two and be like, holy crap, you know, I have progressed a lot. So number one is just track, all right? I tracked everything when I was, number one, going from skinny to muscle, right? When I was building muscle, I was tracking everything. And then when I was at my goal, you know, I wasn't really tracking that much because I was able to like maintain that very easily. Again, when you get to your goal, when you reach your goal, you're gonna be able to maintain a lot easier than to transform. And then when I went from, you know, 190 to 250, I had to start tracking again. Every single time you try to transform anything in your life, you gotta track. You gotta, you know, what they say, there's a quote, they say that whatever is measured grows. That's what you gotta think, all right? Whatever is measured grows, so measure and track your process and your journey. So one, you're able to look back and be like, holy crap, look at the progress I've made. But number two, you're able to see, you know, when you see progress, when you see results. So when you hit a plateau down the road, you're able to go back and be, okay, how did I beat that plateau before? How did I progress before? And then you're able to switch it up. All right, that's number one is track. Number two, you have to have events. You have to have a goal. You have to have something that you are going for. You have to have something that you are, you know, like eyes on the prize. That's gonna help push you past the dirt, past the shit, past the struggle, is eyes on the prize. When I was, again, going from 190 to 250, my eyes and my prize was, you know, going to play at the JC, the junior college. When I was in high school, it was playing on varsity. You know, when I cut back down, it was to, you know, inspire you guys, but you have to have an event, you have to have a goal. You can't just be working out or try to transform and you don't have a goal you're trying to reach or something that you're venting, a goal, you know, an event or something that when you are in pain, when you want to quit, when you don't think you could do another freaking rep, then that goal or that vent is gonna help you push past those extra two reps, that extra 5 pounds. You need that to help push you past the struggle, the pain, okay? That's number two. Number three is get yourself a partner, get yourself a trainer, get yourself a coach. It doesn't matter what it is, but you need someone to keep you accountable. Look, after work, I get it, okay? You're tired, you know, you had, you know, your boss yell at you today, you know, you come home to either, you know, kids barking up and like, you know, giving you stress, maybe the wife, maybe the spouse is giving you a little bit because you didn't freaking clean your dishes last night. Maybe you come home and your mom or your dad are just, you know, getting on you, get your homework done, whatever it is. You had a long freaking day. It's easy to say, you know, I'm not gonna go to the gym today, I'm just tired, you know, do it tomorrow. But it is not easy to say, when you commit to somebody that I'm going to be at the gym at this time, I'm going to go at this day, it is not easy to tell them, you know, I'm not going to go today. You know, I had a long day. You know, you're going to let that person down. You're going to, you know, that person is relying on you. That person is expecting you to be there. You're not going to do that to that person. All right. You're not going to let that person just be at the gym by themselves. You're going to go to the gym. You're going to say, this is a long day, but I got to go meet Jenny at the gym. I got to go meet Jake at the gym, man. I got to go meet Jordan at the gym, man. Like, you're going to go to the freaking gym and not let them down. So get yourself a partner, get yourself a training partner, get yourself a coach, a trainer, something where it can keep you accountable, because I'm telling you, it's gonna be too easy to let yourself down, all right? I've dealt with it with clients, I've dealt with it with myself, I've dealt with it with friends. It's so easy to let yourself down, but it's so much harder to let someone else down, okay? So get yourself a partner. That's number three. Number four, all right? And number four is very important, so make sure that you hear this one very clearly. Your environment, your atmosphere, all right? Who you spend the most time around, where you go, you know, during your free time. Are you, you know, what you're consuming? Are you consuming, you know, bullshit? Are you consuming, you know, world star hip hop? Are you consuming, you know, these bad YouTube videos that are just promoting, you know, violence and criminal crimes and all this kind of stuff? Or are you consuming positivity, optimistic, you know, content? Are you getting out there and getting motivated? Are you getting out there and learning something? Are you surrounding yourself with people who are trying to make you better? Are you surrounding yourself with people who are trying to make you worse? Maybe subconsciously, maybe you don't know yet, but are you with someone who is literally gonna tell you the truth and say, hey, you know, I love you. You know, you're my good friend. But look, you know, these things that you're doing are not gonna get you to the results that you're talking about, all right? Or do you have the friends that are like, hey, forget that, let's just do this, or forget that, let's go out and, you know, get fucked up, or let's go out and drink, or let's go out and smoke, whatever it is. You know, who is in your environment? Who is in your atmosphere? Who are the five people? You've probably heard the quote, and if you haven't, the quote is, you are the average of the five people you surround yourself with. Who are those five people? Who are those five people for you? Because I'm telling you, those five people are influencing you whether you like it or not, all right? I'm telling you, I promise you. So get your right environment, get your right atmosphere, get the right people. If you don't have the right people with you right now, it's okay, no problem, don't stress out. All you gotta do is go to the gym and I guarantee you find at least one, all right? There's one person. Next place you go is go to the library. I guarantee you find someone there. Next place to go, maybe go out and go to the beach or go to the park or go outdoors, you know? Go find someone who's, you know, doing something for themselves, being productive, you know? Go to a coffee shop and find someone hustling and grinding on a computer all day. You know, you see them in there like five times a week. Like, this guy is always here grinding on his computer. Maybe go talk to him, but hey, you know, I just wanna say, I've noticed, you know, you've been working really hard these last couple days. I just wanna introduce myself. You know, I'm new to the area. Even if you're not new to the area, just say that. You know, it's an easy way to break the ice. I'm new to the area, don't know many people. Are you from here? You know, just go meet new people to be able to get the right people in your atmosphere, get the right people in your environment, all right? And that takes effort. They're not just gonna fall into you. They're not just gonna fall into your life. You have to make that happen, all right? So that's number four is environment and atmosphere. And number five, guys, is plan of action. Do you have the right plan of action? Are you taking the right steps? Do you have the right plan to get you to your goal? Look, if you're trying to gain muscle, all right, if you're trying to gain muscle and you are swimming all the time and you are, you know, going on a mile run and you are, you know, maybe lifting like really light weights for a lot of reps, do you think you're gonna be building muscle? I don't care if you do that every single day for a year, you're not gonna be building muscle. It's the wrong plan of action, all right? If you're trying to build muscle, you gotta lift heavy weights, you know, anywhere from, you know, low reps heavyweight or like 8 to 12 hypertrophy, you know, you gotta have the right plan of action. All right, you could be doing everything every day and having the wrong plan of action will not get you to your goal. And if you don't know the right plan of action and you need help, well, DM me. Go ahead and put in the comments saying, I need help on my plan of action, and I'll help you with your plan of action, all right? But you need the right plan of action. You could be doing, executing on this and that and this and that every single day, but you could be going in the wrong direction. And then the more and more and more and more and more you do the wrong things, you're going farther and farther and farther away from your goals. So what you gotta do is number one, start tracking. Track everything, all right? What is measured grows, all right? So track. Number two is you gotta have a vent, you gotta have a goal, you gotta have, you know, something that you're looking towards, something that you're looking forward to, an event, a race, a show, whatever it is, have something that you're looking forward to. Number three is, what was number three? Number three, partner, training partner, coach, something, someone to keep you accountable, to make sure that, you know, you don't flake on yourself, because I know you're not gonna flake on them, so you gotta get a partner, whoever it is, find yourself a partner. Number four, very important, very, very important, atmosphere and environment. You get the right atmosphere, you get the right environment, you get the right people around you, just watch your results in the next week, in the next month, in the next 3 months. Guarantee you grow, guarantee you get better, guaranteed, all right? Atmosphere and environment, and then number five, the right plan of action, all right? Have the right plan of action, do your research, ask, you know, someone who is, you know, in that field, or ask someone who is an expert, and help, and ask them for help for your plan of action. Ask that person who knows a little bit more than you for some help. Be like, how do I get from point A to point B, all right? Don't be shy, ask for help. Don't have your ego stop you from getting to your goal, all right? Let the ego go, leave it at the door, humble yourself and ask for help, all right? Especially if you don't know, okay? Those are my five tips to help you transform your body, to help you transform your health, your fitness, and really you can use those five for any other area of your life, for your work, for your career, for your relationships, for school, but those five are gonna help you transform your life. So hope you enjoyed that. I go ahead and do back and buy workout right here. I'll go ahead and leave a little screenshot so you can screenshot the workout, try it out yourself. I started off with just some pull-ups. I didn't film those. And then I went to a seated cable row, did some cable curls. And then I went from the cable curls over to lat pull downs. You know, not too heavy, but enough to where, you know, I'm able to get like about 10 reps. Then from lat pull downs, I go to barbell rows. From barbell rows, I go over to bent over RDL two row. So I go ahead and perform one RDL, pretty heavy, and then I do a row and then I come back up. And I do an RDL, do a row, come back up. Do an RDL, do a row, come back up. So I did that and then I switched up, or I supersetted those with alternating dumbbell curls. Guys, this workout's pretty damn good. You're gonna feel an amazing pump on your biceps. Highly recommend it for your next back and bye day. Let me know what you thought. And again, guys, I just wanna say how much I appreciate every single one of you guys watching my videos, you know, the comments, the feedback, what you guys are, you know, messaging me. I can't appreciate you guys anymore. I appreciate every single one of you guys. If you guys have a question you want me to answer, put it in the comments down below, all right? If you wanna go ahead and look in the description, I have a free bodyweight plan for you to grab for yourself. Again, no equipment needed. Bodyweight, 30 minutes on average. I really highly recommend you go pick that up. And guys, as always, I will see you next workout.